In this video, I'm going to 3D print a walking bike for my son. I don't know yet how, all I have for now is those two wheels. But yes, please join me on my build. I made a quick drawing and this is what I have in mind. Like a mountain bike. I want to make a cool bike. After some research, I need to get my 3D printer first. So I got myself one of the cheapest available printers today. It is the Ender 3. You can get this one for under $200. Let's see if it can print a bike frame. Alright, the printer is all set up now. I played around a bit, made some test prints. Let's move on with the bike. Now I have to transfer my little drawing into a real 3D model, so the printer can print it. To do this, I downloaded a free software called Blender. And after some playing around, I managed to make my whole bike frame. I didn't make the frame too fancy because it's the first time for me 3D printing and 3D modeling, so it's pretty straightforward. I printed out a small model to see the proportions. I need to make some adjustments, but overall I'm very happy. Now even though it's a tiny bike I want to print, it's still way too big for the printer, so I have to slice it up into smaller pieces. The last step before printing is to transform those pieces into printable files. I do this with a free software called Ultimaker Cura. I'm sanding down all the connections so they will be smooth and it will be easy fit later on. You might have noticed that my parts are hollow inside. There is no infill. This because I will fill up the whole frame with epoxy to save printing time and to make a really strong frame. Next thing what I will do is I open up all the ends of the parts. So later on when all the parts are connected together, the epoxy can flow through the whole frame and make hopefully a very strong connection. First I will glue all the connections together and then when the whole bike is assembled, I will fill it up with this epoxy. I will add some fibers to make it a bit thicker and stronger. Epoxy is very nice, but it can be nasty for our skin, so keep that in mind. Use some protection and work in a vented area. I drill a small hole in the bottom of my frame so I can fill up the frame with my mixture. The epoxy is done, the frame is rock solid now. Now I will sand down the frame to make it as smooth as possible. I decided to give the frame a last layer of red colored epoxy for extra durability. Keep in mind that the paintbrushes you use for epoxy painting only can be used once because you cannot get the epoxy out of the brush anymore. Yes, the frame is done. I got other parts like a handlebar, seat and front fork. All left to do now is assemble everything and my boy can go for a test ride.
That's the name of my son and the test pilot of this bike. Finished.
Your bike? Let's go. He was really happy to see his bike. It's still a little bit big because he's not even 2 years old, but I'm sure we will have a lot of fun with it. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a like, and if you want to see more projects, consider subscribing to my channel. Cheers!